Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're delving into a topic that affects millions of people worldwide, which is kidney stones. If you've ever experienced that sharp pain in your lower back, you know just how uncomfortable and debilitating kidney stones can be. But fear not, because in this video I'm going to discuss kidney stones, its symptoms, causes, prevention strategies, and treatment options available. The kidneys are remarkable organs that filter waste and excess substances from our blood to produce urine. Kidney stones are hard deposits that develop within the kidneys. They're formed when certain minerals and salts present in the urine crystallize and adhere together over time. These tiny crystals can join to create larger solid structures. There are several types of kidney stones. The most common types include calcium oxalate stones, which are made up of calcium and oxalate, and uric acid stones, formed from uric acid crystals. Less frequently, there are also struvite stones and cystine stones. Kidney stones can vary in size, ranging from tiny grains to larger, more substantial structures. As these stones develop, they might stay within the kidney or move down the urinary tract. When they start to move, they can cause pain and discomfort. It can block ureters. This blockage can cause a backup of urine, which not only results in pain, but can also lead to infection and other complications. Now let's discuss the symptoms of kidney stones. Number 1. Severe pain. The most notable and common symptom of kidney stones is the intense pain. This pain is typically felt in the back or side, usually below the ribs and sometimes radiating down to the lower abdomen or groin. The pain is colicky, that is, it comes and goes in waves and may be accompanied by nausea and vomiting. Number 2. Blood in the urine or hematuria. Another indicator of kidney stones is the presence of blood in the urine. This condition, known as hematuria, can make your urine appear pink, red, or brown. It's important to remember that while hematuria can be a sign of kidney stones, it can also be caused by other conditions, so it's crucial to consult a healthcare professional for an accurate diagnosis. Number 3. Frequent urination. Kidney stones can irritate the urinary tract, leading to increased frequency of urination. Number 4. Painful urination dysuria. Painful urination or dysuria is another symptom that might accompany kidney stones. The irritation caused by the stones as they move through the urinary tract can lead to a burning sensation or discomfort while passing urine. Number 5. Cloudy or foul-smelling urine. Sometimes kidney stones can affect the appearance and odor of your urine. Cloudy or foul-smelling urine can indicate the presence of an infection or the passage of minerals and crystals associated with kidney stones. Now let's talk about the factors that can contribute to stone formation. Number 1. Dehydration. One of the leading causes of kidney stone formation is dehydration. When you don't drink enough water, your urine becomes concentrated, making it easier for minerals and salts to crystallize and form stones. Number 2. Diet high in salt and certain minerals. A diet rich in salt, calcium, and oxalate-containing foods can increase your risk of kidney stone development. Number 3. Obesity and certain medical conditions. Obesity and certain medical conditions such as urinary tract infections and digestive disorders can disrupt the balance of minerals and salts in your body, making you more prone to kidney stone formation. Remember, being aware of these symptoms and understanding the risk factors associated with kidney stones can help you take proactive steps to prevent their formation. If you're experiencing any of these symptoms or if you're concerned about your risk, don't hesitate to consult a medical professional for guidance. Now, it's time to explore powerful prevention strategies that can help keep these troublesome stones at bay. Number 1. Hydration. Staying well hydrated is absolutely crucial in preventing kidney stone formation. Drinking plenty of water throughout the day helps dilute the concentration of minerals and salts in the urine, making it less likely for crystals to form and grow into stones. Number 2. Moderation in sodium intake. Excessive sodium consumption can lead to calcium buildup in the urine. Keep an eye on your salt intake by avoiding processed and fast foods, and instead, season your meals with herbs and spices. Number 3. Limit oxalate-rich foods. Oxalate is a naturally occurring compound found in certain foods that can contribute to kidney stone formation. Especially calcium oxalate stone examples include spinach, rhubarb, and nuts. Number 4. Adequate calcium intake. Contrary to common belief, consuming enough dietary calcium can actually reduce the risk of kidney stone formation. Calcium binds to oxalate in the intestines, preventing its absorption into the bloodstream. Just be sure to get your calcium from healthy sources like dairy products or fortified foods. Number 5. Monitor protein intake. High protein diets, particularly those rich in animal protein, can increase the excretion of calcium and uric acid in the urine. This can contribute to stone formation. Aim for a balanced intake of protein from both animal and plant sources. Number 6. Stay active or exercising. Regular physical activity is not only beneficial for overall health, but also for kidney stone prevention. Exercise improves circulation, which helps maintain proper mineral balance and reduces the risk of stone formation. Number 7. Mind your medications. Certain medications can increase the risk of kidney stones. If you're on medication that might contribute to stone formation, discuss alternatives with your healthcare provider. Never discontinue medications without medical guidance. Number 8. Moderation in alcohol and caffeine. Excessive alcohol and caffeine consumption can lead to dehydration, a risk factor for kidney stones. Number 9. Maintain a healthy weight. Maintaining a healthy weight is vital for kidney stone prevention. Obesity can disrupt the balance of minerals and fluids in your body, increasing your susceptibility to stone formation. Now let's discuss the treatment options for kidney stones. When it comes to kidney stones, there are several treatment options available depending on the size, location, and type of stones, as well as the severity of symptoms. For small stones that are likely to pass on their own, healthcare providers may recommend drinking plenty of water to help flush out the stone. Pain relievers and anti-inflammatory medications can be used to manage pain and discomfort. Medications can be prescribed to help dissolve certain types of kidney stones, such as uric acid stones. Medications might also be given to manage underlying conditions that contribute to stone formation, like urinary tract infections or hyperparathyroidism. Other options include extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy, ureteroscopy, percutaneous nephrolithotomy surgery. Remember, taking care of your kidneys is an essential part of maintaining your overall health. By staying hydrated, eating a balanced diet, and making healthy lifestyle choices, you can significantly reduce your risk of kidney stone formation. If you found this information helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more valuable insights into your well-being. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below.